met nummerplaat XLZ 255 AKG 41312 kan zijn wagen ophalen bij de Rijkswacht. Die is weggesleept omdat de nummerplaat de weg verspert. Dat zal je leren van Mercedes te hebben. Goed, de volgende mensen hebben hun eigen evangelie en het is best de moeite waard. Hier zijn ze, de Whisky Priests.
It's nice to say that some people are still here. You're right! You must all be pissed by now. We've had plenty of time.
Good.
Oh,
time.
Last amount.
Bedtime. Is it bedtime yet? I don't know what presents you got from St. Nicholas, but perhaps you got some of these. We haven't had any yet, but on the 25th of December we hope to get some. All we need is a little bit of mistletoe.
Perhaps you got some of those.
Has everybody got no bites? But me!
could either go and fight the fascist bastards out in Germany, or you could go and dig coal down the pit. And this is a song which was written by a man who chose to go and dig coal in the pit. This is a song called Blackleg Mining Man, and it comes for the 1984 British miners' strike. And blacklegs were people who broke this strike, thereby lowering the standard of the British working class and fucking everybody up. This is a song written by Joe Pubdom called The Blackleg Mining Man.
So you could say this is an angry song. And again.
Who is that blackleg mining man? Who is that blackleg mining man? He's the one who helps the boss nail his brothers to the cross. Who is that blackleg mining man? Where was that blackleg mining man? Where was that blackleg mining man? He was nowhere to be seen when they killed young Jones and Green. Where was that blackleg mining man? He was that blackleg mining man. He was that blackleg mining man. He was deep down in the mine when through the picket line. He was that blackleg mining man. Why does that blackleg mining man? Why does that blackleg mining man dig the black coal, puts his mirrors on the dole? Why does that blackleg mining man someday, that blackleg mining man someday, that blackleg mining man will rue what he has done when there's no work for his son someday? That blackleg mining man one day, that blackleg mining man one day, that blackleg mining man will realize he sold his soul for a tub of blackleg coal one day. That blackleg mining man, he'll see. That blackleg mining man, he'll see. That blackleg mining man, when he looks into his glass, a traitor to his class, he'll see. That blackleg mining man, who is that blackleg mining man? Who is that blackleg mining man? He's the one who helps the boss nail his brothers to the cross. He is that blackleg mining man.
Thank you!
Cheers. A song for better days. I did, but I started again today. And I'll stop again tomorrow.
Right, this one's a bit busier, this is for the bees. Fuck did I say?
Fuck them, yes. There's only one way.
Thank you.
And you!
This one's a new song.
Cheers.
A new song. We don't know it. You don't know it.
Fan club as always. Next month we're going to the Highlands of Scotland to record our new album, and we're going to play some new songs tonight from the new album.
We're going there to record new
album next year.
We'll freeze our knackers off.
This is one of the new ones. It's okay, he never knows where he is, don't worry about it, it's normal. This is a song about trudging to work in the sleet, and the rain, and the mud, and the shit, and having to do a job that you hate. So this is for most people, I think, this is called Going to the Mine.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Christmas this year.
And he's got a mighty pair of lungs on him. He lives under the miles of being
balls on here. Well, but he's got it on my head.
You what?
Massive pitted balls and a great big
one. Glenn's dying for somebody to say it. Yeah. Who's this song for then?
Shaving you.
Cheers. And so that, that was a new one, here's another new one. On new album, think positive! That's what you have to do. Has anybody ever been shit on by somebody who you thought was their best friend? Yeah?
Not literally.
Yeah. Do you ever find that wherever you go in life, there are always fake people who pretend to be your friend and they just shit all over you? But you'll understand what this one's about. This is called Brothers in Arms Again. And it's for anybody who's always had to eat humble pie while somebody else shits on top of you. In return. It's a happy song. Because the one who shat on wins in the end, as always. There you go. Forthcoming album, Think Positive, which will be in the shops sometime next year. We hope to come back to Belgium in May or June, and the Netherlands too, promoting the album. We'll see you then. A few more songs to go, but first, you must sing! Yes!
Can you sing?
Oh, yes you can!
Can I just, what's wrong with this song? Does it smell? Does everyone agree?
It's this side of the stage, I think.
He's okay. Oh,
can't you speak fucking English?
He's right.
He's
right.
You can't all that if you like your mate. Can't you speak fucking English, mate?
Yeah, I can, but you can't.
Can't you speak fucking English? You know, London, you know, London, you're talking.
It's a fucking London, isn't it?
Fucking London, isn't it?
At least I live south of the Arctic Circle.
Sorry, you have to excuse us for a moment while this side of the stage takes the piss out of this side of the stage. In the meantime, this is called Mother Waiting, and this is about a mother waiting in vain for a soldier boy's son to come home from. And you will learn it as we play it, and you will raise the roof so high that Haley's comet will fail the fucking impact.
And you will sing it in English.
Yes, indeed. Mother Waiting.
It's fucking easy in English.
And all the fields she knows, a
king who has killed much time than kill a gentle son.
Thank you.
about a bloke called William.
Okay, we've just had orders. I don't know if it's last orders, but we've got two. We've got orders to play two more. So, otherwise we get sent to bed without any supper. This is a song off our new album. We haven't recorded it yet, but we're going to. This is the story of the car boot sale. Whatever that is.
Put your hand up if you know what a car boot sale is!
You haven't a fucking clue, have you?
Do you know what a car boot sale is? Put your hand up.
What is it? Tell us what it is.
A car boot sale is when all the fuckwits in Britain get together on a race course or a piece of fucking waste ground, and they take the cars and they fill the cars with all the old junk and tidbits and any old bits of shit that they have in the house. They put it in the boot of the car, they drive all the way to the big empty field, they open the boot of the car and they sell everything to all the other fuckwits who come along and part with all the money. You understand? Yes! And you know something? It's the best place to go if you want to buy cheap CDs or anything like that.
There's some cheap ones over there as well.
Here we go. If you want to buy any bits of broken crockery, that's the place to go. Yeah? Yeah! This is a moment that's called the car boot sale.
Cheers!
Thank you.
Thank you, I hope you've had a good night. Thanks to Snakes in Exile and Care Passer, we enjoyed them, I hope you did. I hope you've had a good night. Sing along, if you know the words.
Happy St. Nicholas Day!
Thank you.
Dolly's doodle doll. Dolly's doodle doll. Dolly's doodle doll.
Thank you.
quiet soul.
Thanks for listening. We have CDs and t-shirts over there. This is acoustic. This is for the police.
Leave her, Johnny, leave her.
Christmas.
Nothing is said or reason of bread. We're stuck in the
Choice. You could either go and fight the fascist bastards out in Germany, or you could go and dig coal down the pit. And this is a song which was written by a man who chose to go and dig coal in the pit. This is a song called The Blackleg Mining Man, and it comes for the 1984 British miners' strike. And blacklegs were people who broke this strike, thereby lowering the standard of the British working class and fucking everybody up. This is a song written by Jock Purdom, called The Blackleg Mining Man.
So you could say this is an angry song. And again.
Who is that blackleg mining man? Who is that blackleg mining man? He's the one who helps the boss nail his brothers to the cross. Who is that blackleg mining man? Where was that blackleg mining man? Where was that blackleg mining man? He was nowhere to be seen when they killed young Jones and Green. Where was that blackleg mining man? He was that blackleg mining man. He was that blackleg mining man. He was deep down in the mine when through the picket line. He was that blackleg mining man. Why does that blackleg mining man? Why does that blackleg mining man take the black, black coal, puts his mirrors on the dole. Why does that blackleg mining man someday, that blackleg mining man someday, that blackleg mining man will rue what he has done when there's no work for his son someday. That blackleg mining man one day, that blackleg mining man one day, that blackleg mining man will realize he sold his soul for a tub of blackleg coal one day. That blackleg mining man he'll see, that blackleg mining man he'll see, that blackleg mining man, when he looks into his glass, a traitor to his class he'll see. That blackleg mining man who is, that blackleg mining man who is, that blackleg mining man, he's the one who helps the boss nail his brothers to the cross. He is that blackleg mining man. Thank you.
Thank you. the rubbish shell on all nightstands of old. The carton niche, nostalgia in the dial's light of old. And the features of whose wondrous face would shine like a million stars. Ah, but it's cracked and one is life's long withdrawn. These were with grief, you know.
To the dark.
tells. Good silly dog.